Good morning, children. This is Grade 3 Science class. We are doing essay 2 revision. Now, today we are going to revise two blocks, block 20, energy, and block 25, natural disasters. So, from these two blocks, you are going to learn all the answers from workbook, classwork, and reader. So, be thorough with the reader, read the lesson, and learn all the answers from workbook and classwork. In workbook, you are having S1 to S4 in each block. Learn all the answers. And the revised important questions you are going to write one time in your classroom.
Open your reader, page number 124, children. Read the lesson, energy, block 20, definition of energy. Kinds of energy, sources of energy, and renewable and non-renewable sources of energy. So read the lesson thoroughly. And we'll see practice questions. What is energy? Explain with examples. So what is energy? Energy is the power to change the things. It is the ability to do work. And examples you have to give. Energy helps us to do things. It gives us light. It runs our motorcycles. It helps to cook the food. And seventh one, what is the difference between renewable and non-renewable sources of energy? Give two examples of each. So what is renewable source of energy? A source of energy that can be reproduced or replenished is called renewable source of energy. Examples, wind, water, biomass and sun are renewable source of energy. A source is said to be non-renewable if it cannot be replenished. A non-renewable source can be present in large amounts, but regular or excessive use can lead to its depletion. So what are the examples of non-renewable source of energy? Coal, natural gas, and petroleum. So you have to give the definition of renewable and non-renewable source of energy. Even you have to write examples. So these two answers you are going to write from practice questions from reader. And from workbook, S1, you have to read all the answers. From S1, you have to write second one. A weightlifter is lifting a heavy weight. Does the weightlifter have energy? Why? Yes, the weightlifter has energy. He is able to change the position of the weight. So from S1, you have to write second one and practice all the examples of different kinds of energies. Even you have to practice the pie chart. And from S3, you have to write first one, which energy source is the most used in India and which is the second most used energy source. So coal is the most widely used source of energy and petrol is the second most used source of energy. Even you have to practice the different examples of sources of energy. From S3, you are going to write first one. And from S4, renewable and non-renewable source of energy, write first one. Fuels for vehicles are being developed from plants and can be used instead of petrol or diesel. Such fuels are called biofuels. Do you think biofuels are renewable source of energy? Why? Yes, biofuels are renewable source of energy as we get them from plants. Plants grow back quickly. So write this first one from S4. Now we'll see block 25, children. Block 25, natural disasters. We have learned the different natural disasters, floods, drought, earthquake and tsunami. Read the lesson thoroughly and learn the glossary. And from practice questions, you have to write first one, what is natural disaster? Name some natural disasters. So what is a natural disaster? Natural disaster is a change in nature that causes damage to people, animals and plants. Some natural disasters are floods, drought, cyclones and tsunamis. And how is a drought different from a flood? So drought happens when there is no rain for a long time and rivers and streams dry up. But floods happen when water from nearby water bodies flow onto the land. So you have to give the difference between drought and flood. From practice questions, you are writing first and third one. Now we'll see the workbook part. Now open your workbook, S1. learn all the answers from S1. Write third one. Write one way in which we can prevent floods from occurring. Stop cutting trees. And from S2, learn all the answers, but write second one. What can people affected by drought do? Use water carefully and stay indoors and avoid direct sunlight. So write this second one. And from S3, you have to write what should people do during an earthquake and after an earthquake. So what should people do during an earthquake? Hide under the table or any other furniture, go to an open place. And after an earthquake, do not go back indoors for some time. If stuck indoors, cover your head, make sound by hitting something. So write this second one from S3. S4, you have to write what causes a tsunami. When an earthquake happens under a sea or ocean, big waves are formed. When these waves hit the shore, they cause tsunami. So what the major cause of tsunami, you have to write. Learn all the other answers, children. Read the lesson thoroughly and practice all the questions from reader, classwork and workbook. And do your exam well, children.